Welcome to our service of remembrance. For those of you who have not been here before, sit back and enjoy. May your hearts be softened and you enjoy it. I encourage you to silence your cell phones, and I'll tell you that there's a secret bathroom through this door. And so if you're in a hurry, go through this door. Let's begin with our call to worship, which is Psalm 148. Calling all creation, give praise to God. You angels in heaven, sing out glory. You stars, sun, and moon, shine bright with praise. God dreamed and called you, and here you are. You fish and whales and squid, sing praise in the deep. You elements of nature, fire, rain, wind, cold and heat, stone and mountain, praise. God dreamed you and called you, and you are here. You plants and forests, praise God as you flower and fruit. You mammals, insects, reptiles, and birds, praise. God dreamed you and called you, and you are here. You people, tall and short, rich and poor, quiet and loud, in every corner of planet Earth, God dreamed you and called you, and here you are. So listen for the name that is above every name. Worship all with the love and joy that you find, for all you are all made by God, and all that you have is a gift of God. Calling all creation, come and be found in praise. Amen.
Thank you. chapter 9, verse 16. Whenever the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it, and I will remember the everlasting covenant between God and all the living creatures of every kind on the earth.
Please rise and join me in prayer. Let us give thanks to God, our Creator, for all the gifts He has given us. We thank you, God, for the sun and the moon, the stars and the planets. We thank you, God, for wind and cloud, rain and sun. We thank you, God, for water to drink, to play in, to bathe in, baptism. We thank you, Lord, for fire that gives light in the darkness and warmth in the cold. We thank you, Lord, for the earth that feeds us and protects us. We thank you for the flowers, trees, grass, and bushes.
stood by your bed last night. I came to have a peek. I saw that you were crying. You found it hard to sleep. I whispered to you softly as you brushed away a tear. It's me. I haven't left you. I'm well. I'm fine. I'm here. I was close to you at breakfast. I watched you pour your tea. You were thinking of the many times your hands reached down to me. I was with you at my grave today. You tend it with such care. Just want you to know that I'm not really lying there. You sat there very quietly, then smiled. I think you knew, in the stillness of that moment, I was very close to you. I'm here, so close beside you, so near you every day. Believe me when I tell you, I never went away.
They will not go quietly. They will not go quietly, the pets who shared our lives. In subtle ways, they let us know their spirit still survives. Old habits still can make us think we hear them at the door, or step back when we drop a tasty morsel on the floor. Our feet still go around the place the food dish used to be, and sometimes, coming home at night, we miss them terribly. And although time may bring new friends and a new food dish to fill, the one place in our heart belongs to them and always will.
Come, stop your crying. It'll be all right. Just take my hand, hold it tight. I will protect you from all around you. I will be here, don't you cry.
For one so small, you seem so strong. My arms will hold you, keep you safe and warm. This bond between us can't be broken. I will be here, don't you cry. 'Cause you'll be in my heart. Yes, you'll be in my heart. From this day on, now and forevermore. You'll be in my heart. No matter what say, you'll be here in my heart always.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The Creatures of the Creator is shedding light on animal abuse and neglect in Pennsylvania. You may have noticed the cross in the grass as you drove in. The problem is, most people don't. They just drive by. They drive by the poor, voiceless, helpless animals left behind, the backyard breeders, the pit bull fighting, the animals living their entire lives on a heavy train. The bottom line is, if you see something, do something. Report it. The insert on Libre's law was enacted in 2017. The law, inspired by a Boston Terrier puppy who was found badly neglected and abused in Lancaster County. Libre's law is an anti-cruelty law that strengthen protection for animals and increase penalties for animal abuse in Pennsylvania, including the ability for aggravated animal cruelty to be charged as a felony. The problem is the lack of funding for humane officers to investigate cruelties, cases going unreported, and so on and so on. Laws need to be strengthened and enacted, and criminals need prosecuted at the highest level. I personally will be advocating for change and laws to be enacted. If you could please join me now in a prayer for animals. Hear our humble prayer, O God, for our friends, the animals, especially the animals who are suffering, for any that are hunted or lost or deserted or frightened or hungry, for all that will be put to death. We entreat them for all thy mercy and pity, and for those who deal with them, we ask a heart of compassion and gentle hands and kindly words. Make us ourselves to be true friends to animals, and so to share the blessings of the merciful. Amen. Please always adopt, don't shop, and spay and neuter. Thank you.
Never again will they hunger, never again will they thirst. The sun will not beat upon them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd. He will lead them to springs of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Please join me in reading Psalm 23, verses 1 through 6. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life.
Pray with me. Great one, may the meditations of all our hearts and the words that fall from our lips be truth. And may you be our rock and our redeemer. Amen. So our scripture reading today for the reflection is Psalm 36, 5 through 9. You're welcome to read the rest of the psalm, but it reads, your loyal love, mighty one, extends to the skies. Your faithfulness reaches to the clouds. Your righteousness is like the strongest mountain. Your justice is like the deepest sea.
Mighty one, you save both humans and animals. Your faithful love is priceless, God. Humanity finds refuge in the shadow of your wings. They feast on the bounty of your house. You let them drink from your river of pure joy. Within you is the spring of life. In your light, we see light. The psalm points to God's involvement in all creation. Now, when I say that, I'm kind of preaching to the choir, because you all believe that already. All creation is in praise to God and has purpose and meaning, and God loves the creation. Unity Presbyterian Church calls our ministry that sponsors this service creatures of the Creator. That counts all of you. It's not just about pets, it's about the people. It's both. We're not raising up animals to be where we are. They are already placed that way. Humanity has misunderstood what God has done. We're not the pinnacle. We are the tenders. We are those that are meant to care for, to watch over. God saves humans and animals. It's right there, Psalm 36, 6. God helps and aids. God has more than just a vested interest in the creation. God is trustworthy to care. Humans and animals. So in our sadness, because this is a service of remembrance and everybody's about to see their beloved beings and there's going to be like this very poignant moment. And then we're going to hear about a grief counseling ministry for people who have this very poignant moment and can't seem to process it. But in our sadness, God is our place of refuge because God cares for us and for the animal. And I'm going to tell you, God cares for your pet more than you do. Really. That's not a slam on anybody here. God created you and cares for you more than your animal cared for you. And God cares for your animal more than you do. And that's beautiful, not sad. So in our sadness, God is our place of refuge. We are invited to find refuge in the shadow of God's wings. We can feast on the bounty of God's house. We can drink from the river of pure joy. Within each person here is the spring of life. In God's light, we see light. And so we don't have to descend into the gloom of depression and sadness that is not of God. We can live into the sadness and the yearning that is in the heart of God. God's priceless, faithful love is with you. So trust and hope in that love, because God saves the people and the animals. God is our help and our hope for each pet and for each of you. And so take hope. Amen.
Our psalm reading, Isaiah chapter 40, verses 26 and 28. Lift your eyes and look to the heavens. Who created all these? He who brings out the starry hosts one by one and calls them each by name. Because of his great power and mighty strength, none of them is missing. The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. We will now have the time of remembrance. As your photo and your name is called, please come up, light a candle. You'll hear the sound of the chime and receive a gift of remembrance. Thank you.
if we're apart, now we're joined at the heart, though our moment may be gone, you and I will still live on.
I will always be with you, I'll be by your side, whatever you do. Other memories may fade, but the ones that we made are eternal as a star. Now I'm part of who you are,
and I'll be there with you. Sound of your laughter, I'll be in the tears you cry.
'Cause the way you and I have touched one another
doesn't end with goodbye.
I will always be with you.
For many of us, losing a companion animal is a devastating experience. We often feel overwhelming grief. You don't have to face this alone. Hearts and Paws Ministry at Christ Church has developed a pet grief support group to help people through this trying time. We're hopeful that this group will provide emotional healing and moral support for its members. Everyone is welcome. The support group meets on the second Monday of each month at 7:00. For those people who may not be comfortable in a group setting, we also offer one-on-one meetings. There is a card in your bulletin which describes our grief care along with our contact information. We're here to offer compassion and understanding at this difficult time. Thank you.
Would you please join me in reading the blessing? You may remain seated. Blessed are you, God of the universe. In your infinite wisdom, you created all living creatures for our mutual respect and sustenance. Especially, you entrusted us with the care of our pets, our dear friends, who bring us joy and happiness, and whose presence helps us through trying times. As our pets trust us to take care of them, help us to remember to trust you to take care of us. For in so doing, we share in your love for all your creatures. Remind us of your power, Lord, as we pray for the endangered species, the abused and neglected animals, the service dogs, and all the emotional support animals. We ask your help in taking care of them so we may continue to appreciate all of your creations. Grant us all these things as we ask them in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
May you be consoled, but may you also console, because you know that you have a God who loves you. Now may the Holy Spirit come upon each in this room. May you know the Holy Spirit. And may that change everything, now and forever. Amen.